Morning YouTube, welcome back to the channel. Hope everyone's doing all right. I'm back today. This is one of my regulars. I did a video, I've done a couple of videos, but I did a video of tidying up the border there, I think, back in the autumn. But I'm just back today, just doing some tidying up. It's probably only my second visit back, I think, since I stopped back in December probably, so there's lots of tidying up to do. Got all the grasses, it's a bit of a mess. Like I say, literally hasn't been touched over winter at all, so we've got the grasses to cut down because they'll be shooting up, and all the other bits also. Some of the lavenders need tidying up, and there's lots of other stuff to tidy. Hydrangeas need sorting out. There's buddleia as well, so yeah, lots of bits to tidy up, and the grasses, like I say, I'll run the hedge cutter through them, and then they need a good rake up all the dead bits. So yeah, I'm gonna get started on this now. There we go. So those are miscanthus. And obviously, as you can see, you can give them a good trim right back, and then all the new growth can start coming up. Also, the other thing that's quite good to do with these is you can split the clumps up and spread them around to other parts of the garden if need be. So they're really good for that as well. Just thought I'd have a quick look at the beech tree that I moved back in the autumn. Of course, wet air. See how it's doing. I think it's survived. Looking at it. Have a look, yeah. There we go, good way to check is just peel a slight bit of bark and see if it's green underneath, which that is. And it looks like the buds are swelling up nicely. I think it's survived the winter, so we'll keep an eye on that and see how it does. case, we've just got a little fuchsia here, which somehow seems to survive even though deer do their best to eat it, but can't get the lavender right next to it, and they don't like lavender, so I think that deters them a little bit, especially later on in the year once they've got plenty of other stuff to eat. But yeah, we'll see how it goes. We've got a little azalea growing here, which is getting a bit swamped. It's got the cave lamp just to try and stop the deer from eating it. This one has survived the winter, which the one next to it has not. I'll show you in a minute. So I'm just going to tidy up around here quickly just to give it a chance. We've got lots of this. This is verbena, which is seeded all along here. I'm going to pull these ones out because they're actually growing right into this, which we don't want. So we'll just get rid of them. Just to give it a fighting chance. I'm sure the deer will put an end to it if anything does, but hopefully mature enough to survive what the deer throw at it. Maybe eating it. Okay, so that now has got a chance. Now it's clear around it. Put the cage back around it. In fact, one's a bit broken. Get the one from the one next to it which has died. I mean, obviously it's not going to stop them, but if we can make it harder for them to get to it, at least it gives it a bit of a chance. Okay, so we've got this one here, I don't know if you can see it, but there we go. Yeah, that's one and truly dead, that one. Either it didn't survive the summer or Okay, so I'm just about finished for this morning. So I've done this border. It looks a bit better. I mean, there's still more I could do, clearing the leaves out and stuff a bit more, but generally it's ready now for spring. It can all get growing again now. And to be honest, we're in a woodland setting here, shall we say. So you're gonna have a few leaves blowing around, so next time I will tackle this border over here. We've run out of time for today, so I'm going to call that a day on this video. So thanks everybody for watching, and I will catch you on the next video.